Hey, I'm Erin with the City of Durham's Department of Water Management. Have you ever thought about where the water goes after you wash your hands, or take a shower, or flush the toilet? All of that water has to be cleaned before it's returned to nature. This is where our two water reclamation facilities come in to save the day. All of the waste leaving homes, businesses, and industry flows to one of our two water reclamation facilities here in Durham.
Durham sits on a ridgeline that generally runs along Pettigrew Street and the railroad tracks. Wastewater on the north side flows to the North Durham Water Reclamation Facility on East Club Boulevard. The South Durham Water Reclamation Facility on Farrington Road receives wastewater that flows south. Our dedicated staff of certified operators manage these facilities 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, and each facility brings in and treats about 10 million gallons a day. It takes some serious microbiology to transform our wastewater into clean water, ready to enter the receiving stream.
Let's take a tour to see how that happens. Welcome to the North Durham Water Reclamation Facility.
We start our tour at the most odorous and least appealing place, the bar screens. At this point, the water looks like this. We call this raw water coming into the plant influent. Water passes through the bar screen, which looks like an oversized cone with teeth spaced about a quarter of an inch apart. This effectively screens out anything that goes down the drain or toilet that isn't beneficial to the treatment process. It's amazing what people will flush down the toilet. Just because you can flush it doesn't mean you should. Keys, money, bones, and other trashy bits make their way through our sanitary sewer system and are removed first thing, since they can be harmful to the treatment process and the equipment. Once this trash is removed, a compactor presses the water out, and all of that inorganic material ends up in a landfill. After passing through the screens, the water enters the grit collection process. The sand, gravel, and sediment will settle out here and then be scraped out with rotating plows, eventually dumping the grit into the dumpster headed to the landfill. Grit can be harmful to the reclamation process and takes up space in the tanks, so getting it out is an important early step. If you take a closer look at the grit dumpster, you'll see that it looks a lot like dirty sand with bits of corn. Did you know that we actually don't digest the outer husks of corn kernels? They come out looking pretty much the same as when they went in. Bet you won't look at an ear of corn quite the same way.
So the water's left grit collection and made its way to the primary clarifier. So let's go take a look at the basin.
During this stage of treatment, the liquids separate from the solids and the grease. Solids will settle to the bottom while the fat floats. We then skim the grease off the top and pump the solids from the bottom. The grease ends up in a landfill, and the solids can eventually be applied as a soil amendment or used as compost. What's left is dissolved solids. These are solids that are not heavy enough to settle in the tank and remain suspended in the water. At this point, the water has a gray tint to it, and the odor is definitely less than appetizing.
Now it's time for the real action in the aeration basin. Billions of microorganisms are hard at work providing the biological processes that drive wastewater treatment.
By controlling the oxygen in this tank, we can create an all-you-can-eat buffet for bacteria like water bears and rotifers. The organisms we rely on in water reclamation are the same ones you'd find in nature. If the water flushed down a toilet went straight to a stream, the biology of the stream would eventually clean it, but it would also destroy the ecosystem. No fish could live in it, and you certainly couldn't swim. We give that process a place where it can happen safely and efficiently. We don't even have to add any of these helpful bacteria. We get plenty of these organisms from the folks who flush. Thanks, Durham. With the help of these tiny, hungry helpers, it takes about 2 days to treat the water that comes into the plant for release back into the environment. Before the water leaves the aeration stage, North Durham staff take samples here to gauge how our bacteria are doing. Samples are observed to determine how much solids remain in the water and whether we need to adjust the time in the basin, the oxygen levels, or the number of organisms. This is what the water looks like at this stage in the treatment process.
Water leaving the aeration basin makes its way to the secondary clarifier. This is where the water settles even more and lets the solids settle to the bottom.
This tank also helps us balance the number of microorganisms with the amount of food. We can waste out or remove some of these organisms here to keep that balance in check. Our hard-working microscopic bugs group together in the secondary clarifier, creating what we call flock, and then settle at the bottom of the basin. The sludge is scraped out and we can send it back into an earlier stage of treatment to keep eating, apply it to drying beds, or send it to an anaerobic digester. The anaerobic digester holds the sludge in the absence of air to allow for anaerobic bacteria to continue feeding on the sludge. This material is further processed for use as compost or to be added to farmers' fields. Methane gas is a byproduct during this process, and this can be harvested to run our equipment, lowering our carbon footprint by lowering our energy demand.
At this point, the water looks much cleaner, but there's still some work to do. The next part of the process is filtration.
The water now moves through the filter where layers of anthracite coal and sand will catch the last bit of small particles. Removing these fine particles is necessary in order to effectively complete the last step of treatment, disinfection.
We've made it to the last stage of the treatment process, disinfection. Our disinfection process involves ultraviolet light, or UV light.
This super strong light penetrates the cell wall of any remaining organisms, effectively sterilizing the bacteria so that they can no longer reproduce. The water passes through the UV light, and in about 30 to 45 seconds, it is disinfected. This process is effective and safe for people as well as the environment. Water leaving our facility and entering the receiving stream is called effluent, and here's what it looks like. At the North Durham Water Reclamation Facility, this water is discharged into Ellery Creek, which eventually flows into Falls Lake. Fun fact, the water in Falls Lake is treated again to provide the drinking water for the city of Raleigh. Lab tests are conducted for every step of the process. Once we've confirmed our treated wastewater is free of bacteria and harmful viruses, the reclaimed water is ready to be returned to the never-ending water cycle.
Now that you've seen all that goes into recycling water, we hope we can rely on you to help keep the cycle moving. Do your part and remember the three P's: pee, poo, and paper. These are the only things that should be flushed.
What about flushable wipes? Nope. Remember, wipes clog pipes. Fats, oils, and grease should also be kept out of your drain to protect your plumbing, our sewer system, environment, and our water. Do your part and toss those wipes and that grease in the trash.
Thanks for joining us on this tour of the North Durham Water Reclamation Facility. The Department of Water Management takes a lot of pride in our work, bringing your water full circle in the city of Durham, from the clean water at the tap to the used water going down the drain. Over 350 employees do their part to make sure that Durham stays a great place to live, work, and play. For more information, visit durhamsaveswater.org.